"Who is that gentleman?" she asked. "He is booked, madam, as Monsieur Tarzan, of Africa," replied the steward. Rather a large estate, thought the girl, but now her interest was still further aroused. As Tarzan walked slowly toward the smoking-room, he came unexpectedly upon two men whispering excitedly just without. He would have vouchsafed them not even a passing thought, but for the strangely guilty glance that one of them shot in his direction. They reminded Tarzan of melodramatic villains he had seen at the theaters in Paris. Both were very dark, and this, in connection with the shrugs and stealthy glances that accompanied their palpable intriguing, lent still greater force to the similarity. Tarzan entered the smoking-room and sought a chair a little apart from the others who were there. He felt in no mood for conversation, and as he sipped his absinthe he let his mind run rather sorrowfully over the past few weeks of his life. Time and again he had wondered if he had acted wisely in renouncing his birthright to a man to whom he owed nothing.